Under metrology, third unit is taper and internal dia measurement. First unit is we have seen limits, fits and tolerances. Second unit is we have seen angle measurements. And the third unit is taper and internal dia measurements. See, even though we have many angle measuring equipments for measuring angles, for some components, we can't measure angles using those equipments. So, the taper angle of those components can be measured by measuring linear dimensions of those components, okay, with help of balls, rollers, depth gauge, height gauge and micrometer, okay. For gate exam, under this topic we have eight important cases for solving problems. We'll see one by one, okay. So the case one is, they've asked us to find taper angle for this component, okay, using two rollers of diameter D1 and D2, they are different diameters, okay, with help of depth gauge. Please read the question carefully, okay. If in the question, if they are given, it is depth gauge, then we have to mark this height with respect to top plane of the component. If in the question, if they are given height gauge, then we have to mark this height with respect to bottom plane of the component, okay. That is rule number one. So before solving this, first you have to know what is R and H value. Okay, R is nothing but radius of this rollers. H2 is the distance between this top plane to the top plane of this roller. Same way, H1 is equal to the distance between top plane of this component to top plane of this roller. Okay, so we have to calculate this angle. The total angle is theta, but we have to know only the taper angle. So, I'll explain this diagram here, okay? See, for better visibility, I've just enlarged this triangle, okay? We need to just find this taper angle. The total angle between A and B is theta, but we need to find this taper angle, that is theta by 2. So, we need to find angle between A and O2. So, for finding this angle between A and O2, we can update tan theta. Tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite side by adjacent. So we need to find this opposite side and adjacent sides. Okay. See, the distance between the center point O1 to this point is R1. Okay. And the distance between A to this point is R2. So if you find the difference between R2 minus R1, you can easily find the opposite side. Okay. See, for finding out this adjacent height, I'll tell you one small tip, okay. It is applied for all cases. See, find the total height of the component, okay. Total height is H1 plus R1. That is, total height refers to distance between the top of the component to O1. But we need to find just the distance between A and O1. But we need to find the total height between top of the component to O1, that is H1 plus R1. After finding out this total height, you please neglect the unnecessary height, that is H2 and R2. So, minus H2, minus R2. And just applying tan theta. Tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite is R2 minus R1 by H1 plus R1 minus H2 minus R2. Okay, after this, H1 plus R1 minus H2 minus H2 plus R2. So this formula is required, okay. You just remember how to solve these kinds of problems. Don't mother all these formulas, okay. And coming to case 2. Case 2 is having two rollers with height gauge. As I said earlier, height gauge means you have to measure the height from bottom of the component, okay. H1 is the distance between bottom of the component to top plane of the roller 1, and H2 is the distance between bottom of the component to top plane of the roller 2. Okay, and I'm just expanding this triangle here. Okay, so we need to find this taper angle, that is theta by 2. Tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is just R2 minus R1, adjacent side alone varies. For finding out this adjacent side, as I said earlier, take the total height, that is height between a distance between bottom of the component to top of the roller, that is H2. Okay, H2 and neglect the unnecessary height, that is minus R2 minus H1 plus R1, minus H1 plus R1. Then applying tan theta, tan theta by 2 is equal to R2 minus R1 by H2 minus R2 minus H1 plus R1. Okay, then H2 plus R1 minus H1 plus R2. Please don't mark all this thing. You just remember the method how to solve. Okay. Under taper and internal dia measurement, third case is they have asked us to find the taper angle for this taper ring gauge with an help of two rollers and depth gauge. Okay. Please see the question carefully. They have given depth gauge. Depth gauge means we have to mark height with respect to top plane of the component. We have to mark height with respect to top plane of the component. H2 is the distance between top plane of the component to top plane of the roller. That is roller 2. That is roller 2. And H1 is the distance between top plane of the component to top plane of the roller 1. Okay. And D1 is nothing but diameter of roller 1. And D2 is diameter of roller 2. Okay. So for finding out this taper angle, that is just half of the angle, that is theta by 2. I am going to expand this triangle here. Okay. After expanding this triangle, we need to find theta by 2. So we can apply sin theta. Sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. We all know that opposite side is always same, that is R2 minus R1. See, for reading this R2 minus R1, that is the distance between O2 and this point is R2, and the distance between O1 and this point is R1. So for reading this distance, we have to find the difference between R2 minus R1. And for hypotenuse side, as I said earlier, first take the total height, that is height, the distance between top of the component to O1, the distance between top of the component to O1, that is H1 plus R1, H1 plus R1. And after taking the total height, you please neglect the unnecessary heights, that is minus H2 and minus R2. Okay. So after finding out the values of opposite and hypotenuse side, just substitute again. Sin theta by 2 is equal to R2 minus R1 by H1 plus R1. I am taking the minus sign common here, and H2 plus R2. As simple as that. Okay. Please don't mark this formula. Okay. Please be clear how to solve these kinds of problems. That is important. Okay. And one more small thing. See, only for taper ring gauge you will be getting sin theta here, but for other cases you will be getting tan theta. Okay. You just remember that. Okay. And coming to case 4. Case 4 is taper plug gauge. Case 4 is taper plug gauge. So let us consider a component having a shape of triangles. Okay. See, before solving this first, you have to know what is S, what is D, and what is M. See, we are going to find a taper angle for this plug gauge using three important main components. First one is roller. We are having two rollers on each side having diameter D1 and D2. Both rollers are having different diameters. And second component is slip gauges for measuring the distance between bottom of the component to bottom plane of the roller is S1. And same way, the distance between bottom of the component to bottom plane of this roller 2 is S2. Same way, M1 and M2 are distance between outer diameter of these two rollers, that is D2 is M2, and the distance between outer diameter of these two rollers, that is D1 is M1. First, you have to know all these specifications. Okay. If in the question, if they given us taper plug gauge, then use this formula. Tan theta by 2 is equal to M2 minus M1 by 2 into S2 minus S1. That is, taking as a, see, I am going to divide each section. I am going to divide this taper plug gauge into three sections. Okay. If you apply tan theta here, tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is nothing but M2 minus M1 by 2 into S2 minus S1. See, this formula is valid if two slip gauges are given. This formula is valid if two slip gauges are given. If there is If there is only one slip gauge, okay, then you have to use this formula. Tan theta by 2 is equal to m2 minus m1 by s. Only one slip gauge. And this formula is valid for final section of the component. That is, tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite section is x. Opposite distance is s by adjacent side is whole height is h. Whole height is h minus this s2. H minus s2 minus this r2 value. See, this s is starting from bottom of the component to bottom plane of the roller. Okay, so h minus s2 minus this r, this radius of roller. If you subtract these two values, we'll be getting this adjacent side. You'll be getting this adjacent side. And name it as y. This is nothing but y. Okay, so for gate exam, you have to remember this formula. Tan theta by 2 is equal to m2 minus m1 by 2 into s2 minus s1. And this formula also. You have to know how we are reading this formula. That is more important. Okay, please don't work. Okay. You have to know all these specifications. Okay. Under taper and internal dia measurement, fifth case is single dowel tail. They ask us to find taper angle for this single dowel tail using two rollers and micrometers. Okay. I have just enlarged this triangle, okay, for better visibility. So, for this we can apply tan theta. Tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. But you have to find this opposite side and adjacent side. For this, we know that the distance between O2 and the base of this component is R2. The distance between O2, that is the center of roller 2, to the base of this component is R2. The distance between O1 to the base of this component is R1. So for finding out this unknown, distance, you have to find the difference of R2 minus R1, that is R2 minus R1. And coming to this adjacent side, as I said earlier, first take the whole distance, and after taking the whole distance, you keep on subtracting the unwanted distance, that is M2. Total distance is m2 minus this r2, m2 minus this r2 and minus m1 plus r2 plus r1 minus m1 plus r1. Okay, then substitute the value. Okay, tan theta by 2 is equal to r2 minus r1 by m2 plus r1. I am taking the minus sign common and m1 plus r2. Okay. This is final formula. Please don't mark this formula. You have to remember how we are getting this formula. That is important. This is case 5. And case 6 is two balls inside diameter. See, till case 5 is we have to find the taper angle. And from the case 6 we have to find internal dia. From case 6 we have to find internal dia measurement. That is two balls inside the diameter capital D and slip gauges. In the case 6, first we have to find internal diameter of this component by using two rollers of small diameter D. Okay, these two rollers are having same diameter. Okay, and using these slip gauges we have to find the internal diameter. It is given as capital D is internal diameter of the component. It is given as small diameter is diameter of roller. So 2D, D plus D is 2D plus S is slip gauge, length of the slip gauge, all these values will be given. Okay, so capital diameter is internal diameter of the component is equal to 2D plus S is equal to 2D plus S. Okay, under taper and internal dia measurement, some cases they will ask us to find internal diameter of the component using two balls and depth gauge. The diameter of balls and height value will be given in the question. They will ask us to find internal diameter of the component, that is capital D. It can be found out from capital D is equal to R1 value. Capital D is equal to R1 is nothing but radius of first ball plus O1A plus O1A plus this is R2 value. R2 is radius of second ball. Okay, so we can easily find the values of R1 and R2 because they will give you the diameter of two balls. So we can easily find the radius. Radius is nothing but half of diameter. But the challenging part is finding out this O1A. So, and this enlarging this triangle, okay? This is actually a right angle triangle, right? O1 and O2 are hypotenuse of this triangle. This can be found out from addition of radius of these two balls. See clearly, this is R1 plus R2 gives us O1, O2 values. And coming to this O2A part, as I said earlier, take the whole height. Whole height is nothing but H1 plus this D1 value, this diameter of first ball. H1 plus D1 minus subtract unnecessary height. Unnecessary height is minus H2 minus R2 minus R2 and minus R1 and minus R1. After taking out this whole height and subtract the unnecessary height, okay, so you will be getting the O2A value also. But we need to find this O1A value. So applying Pythagoras theorem, we will be getting the finally O1A is equal to root of O1 O2 square minus O2A square. Okay. So we can easily get the value of O1A. And coming to case 8, that is spin method. It is dynamic method for finding out internal diameter of the component. Okay. See, here we need to find PQ value. We need to find this PQ value. Okay. So we know that OP into PQ is equal to AP into PB. We need to find this PQ value. So PQ is equal to AP into PB by OP. So we have to find this OP value. AP and PB value is given as S by 2. AP and PB value is given as S by 2. So we need to find this OP value. For finding out this OP value, I am going to take this right angle triangle OAP, OPA. We know this length, that is S by 2. We know this length is also, that is L. So OP is equal to, applying Pythagoras theorem, OA square minus AP square. We will be getting OP is equal to OA is L square minus S by 2 the AP is S by 2 the whole square. So PQ is equal to AP is nothing but S by 2 and PB is equal to S by 2 by OP. This is OP value. Okay. So this question is rarely asked in gate exam. Okay. But you have to know what is spin method and how we are going to find the values of PQ. Okay. Thank you.